In last video we have discussed the types of solid, say crystalline solid and amorphous solid. Now we will discuss the types of crystalline solid. Crystalline solids have been classified on the basis of nature of the constituent particles. Crystalline solids have been classified into following four types. For example, molecular solid, second one is ionic solid, third one is metallic solid, and fourth one is covalent or network solid. Covalent solid is also known as the network solid. The name of the molecule, name of the type of crystalline solid indicates the what is the nature of the constituent particles of the crystalline solid. Molecular solid indicates the constituent particles of the crystalline solid will must be molecule. Its constituent particles will be molecules. So the name of the type of crystalline solid is molecular solid. Ionic solid has the constituent particles ions. That is two types of constituent particles, say cation and anion will be the constituent particles of ionic solid. The metallic solid must be the metallic atom. Constituent particles in this case will be metallic atom. On the other hand, covalent solid, that is network solid, the constituent particles of the covalent solid, that is network solid, is atoms, which may be metal or non-metal, usually non-metallic atoms. So it is the covalent solid, that is network solid. It is extended in the three-dimensional shape, so it is also known as the network solid. Molecular solid has the constituent particles molecules, which is neutral in nature, which has not free moving electron, or ions. So molecular solid will be non-conductor in nature. It will be the non-conductor in nature. Ionic solid, although has the constituent particles cations and anions, but they are held together with very strong intermolecular force of attraction in the solid, which cannot be moved. So ionic solids will also be non-conductor in nature. But when ionic solid is in molten state or in aqueous solution, in such case cations and anions will remain free from each other, so that the consequently cations and anions will move from one place to other place, that is they can conduct the electricity. So ionic solid will be conductor. Ionic solid will be conductor in molten state or in aqueous solution. Metallic solids are conductor both in solid state as well as in molten state. Covalent solids in which constituent particle atoms are also held together with very strong intermolecular force of attraction. So covalent solids will also be non-conductor. It is also the non-conductor. Thus conductor only the metallic solid will be the conductor in both solid state as well as in molten state. Ionic solids will be conductor only in the case of molten state or in aqueous solution. In ionic solid, constituent particles are held together by very strong electrostatic force of attraction. So they are hard. Metallic solid are held together by very strong intermolecular force of attraction, which is metallic in bonding, which is metallic in nature. That is, in metallic solid, metallic atoms are held together by metallic bonding, which is also very strong. So it is also hard. But malleable and ductile. Covalent solid, in which constituent particles are held together by covalent bond, so it is also hard. Molecular solid, in which there are three types, in which polar and non-polar solids are usually soft, but hydrogen bonded solids will be hard. Further, melting point of this solid are high, but molecular solids in which melting point will be comparatively less. Molecular solids are further classified into three types, say non-polar solid, polar solid, and hydrogen bonded solid. On the basis of nature of the bonding between the constituent particles of the molecules present in the molecular solid. In other words, on the basis of nature of the bonding, among the constituent particles, the molecular solids have been classified into following three types, say non-polar solid, polar solid, and hydrogen bonded solid. In non-polar solids, the force of attraction between the constituent particles is the London dispersion force, that is Van der Waals force of attraction, which is very weak. So non-polar types of solids are usually gas at room temperature, but when it is in solid state, it will become the non-polar solid. In polar solid, the constituent particles are held together. In molecular solid, will be held together by dipole-dipole interaction. On the other hand, the constituent particles of hydrogen bonded solids are held together by the hydrogen bond. So the name of the solid is hydrogen bonded solid. Non-polar solids, in which force of attraction, that is London dispersion force, is very weak, so it is gas. Polar solid is also exist either in gaseous state or low boiling liquid. On the other hand, hydrogen bond is comparatively strong than the dispersion force, and in dipole-dipole interaction. So hydrogen bonded solids exist usually either in liquid state or in easily volatile solid. For example, water, hydrogen fluoride, ammonia, etc. are the hydrogen bonded solid. That is, these types of compounds exist in exist in hydrogen bonded solid. Thank you.